get some self-adhesive sandpaper and glue it onto a flat surface, piece of MDF, plywood if it's flat, marble, thick piece of glass. And then you can just true that up a little bit. Then go ahead and glue your miter joints together. This is made out of basswood. It was fairly flat, but it is a piece of wood. So invariably, when this gets glue on it or after you've cut it, it'll change or bend a little bit on you, and you may find that you're going to have to adjust some of these joints to get these pipes to turn out nice and square looking. The next project is to put this cap on the air box on the pipe. This pipe is done as far as this is concerned. This has been glued on there. The hole's been drilled for the air hose. I still need to put this piece on here and to make the plug. Get a piece of cardboard. Cut it just about that size. I'm using a piece of cardboard that I got from Michaels, and this happens to be 0.021 inches thick. There seems to be plenty of information out there about how to make pipes, so I'm only going to cover it briefly. You're going to cover this with this piece of cardboard, and we're going to cut that away until it looks about like that. All this is a gasket and a shim to give us a little bit of opening for that air to squirt out of. That's it. You're just cutting this out so that in no way it will interfere with the air that's trying to come out through this slit opening. Doesn't take much glue. I'm just using this wood cap to push that cardboard down flat. Make sure it stays flat until the glue dries. I'll come back and glue this wood cap on in a minute. Okay, that glue has set up a little bit. This piece of wood is just rounded a little bit. When we put it on there, this cardboard creates the gap, and we're going to slide this forward of this piece about a half a millimeter. We don't want to tighten that clamp too tight. We just want it to keep everything flat until that glue sets up. One more time. Just put a little bit of glue on there. Spread it out. That cap on there. Make sure that we overhang about a half a millimeter according to the plans. When that dries, we'll come back and we'll sand the sides and the back flush with the pipe. These pipes have been modified a little bit. There's not a whole lot of room in the back of the organ, and I want to put my electric motor back there, so I had to shift these things around a little bit, make them fit to give me space for the electric motor. Current plan is for this pipe to be like that. This one will be like this. This pipe will be like that, and they will be in the back of the organ like that. This will go up underneath the pressure box. You can see I had to change things a few times before I got everything the way I wanted it. I then found it necessary to modify these three again This one I shortened up so that both sides are close to being the same. I put a jog in this one, and this one used to just come around like this. Now it bends down as well. I put a manifold on here so the air hose can come in from one end. And these have been extended to get them out to where an air hose can come in from one side. I've taken parts and pieces and glued them back together to get these things to conform to the dimensions and configuration that I need, which will be like this. And I've done this because I'm using two different motor drives. One's a left hand, one's a right hand. One will go in one organ, one will go in the other. I don't want to have to do this again for the second organ. This is now configured to take up about as little space as possible. I've used some double-sided carpet tape to hold this together temporary. And this goes up underneath the pressure box. I have one hose that will come in here, one that will come down to here, and one that will come across and go into this pipe here. Be butted up against here, up against the bottom of the pressure box. One motor drive will fit in this way, or like this, very close. I can get that one like that. So that will be good. I can use the left hand or the right hand motor and the organs by following this same layout without having to reinvent the wheel. Blow into these pipes, see what they sound like. In order to mount one of these motors, I made an adapter plate and three of these T-nuts to hold that motor. I located center where I wanted the output shaft for the motor, mounted the plate, and drilled the hole. Mounted the motor onto the adapter plate. The pipes are now mounted very firmly into the organ. There's one screw coming down out of the pressure box and two screws holding it on this side. Now we slide the back of the organ in place. The output adapter I machined before will fit on here. One of the next projects will be to machine a groove, make this a pulley, and to make another pulley to go on the back side of this hand wheel for a belt drive. Looking in through the front of the organ, I have the drive disc for the take-up spool removed because I was mounting the pipes, and you can see the motor. And everything clears.